doesn't get much more impactful and, you know, that picturesque football Americana moment than beating O-State in the Horseshoe in the only game that people are watching at the moment. That was a pretty cool moment.
So, Rich, who was the toughest player that you ever went up against?
You know, I would say the toughest. There's so many. You know, it's so difficult. Like, I would easily say any of the linebackers that I played against on a day in day out basis at Penn State were some of the toughest guys I had to, you know, prepare for. Dan Connor, Paul Posluszny, Navarro Bowman, Sean Lee. Like, these were the guys, my contemporaries at Penn State, who many of which went on to many, many Pro Bowls and success in the NFL. You know, defensive linemen who I faced in my career who gave me trouble. Ndamukong Suh, who just signed with the Rams. I mean, he was a force. He's one of the strongest leverage players in the NFL. And I played him when he was young and really ripping through people. Now, look, I'll tell you, you're gonna face some men when you get on that football field and you have the shield on your chest. It's not easy. And there's a lot of good ones. But, yeah, I would say pretty much all of the Penn State linebackers. Sue was tough. Justin Smith with the 49ers when he was really going. Yeah, those were some of the toughest.
Talking to Rich Ornberger, former NFL offensive lineman and the co-host of the Mark and Rich Show on Extra 1360 Fox Sports San Diego. And, Rich, I'll get you out on this. Are you concerned at all about CTE?
Oh, of course. Yeah. That is, I think, if you're not, you're probably, well, I should, let me preface it with this. If you played football for any extended amount of time at any level, but contact tackle football, where you've taken the amount of head trauma that you will, you know, I had a 6-year NFL career. It's not just the games, it's the practices, it's every single day, it's the off seasons where you're making head-to-head contact, those sub-concussive blows that they are now attributing to some of the symptoms we're seeing with CTE. And, yeah, it's a huge concern. It's something that my wife and I have made some subtle preparations for. I already have a will. You know, I already have my estates in order just in case I lose my faculties. Most, if not all, soon to be, of our financial documentation is in her name. Because should there ever be a moment where I can no longer be what I am today, she has full access to that. It's something that if you're not concerned about, you're probably acting out of fear and ignorance, because it is a real issue and it's something you have to address.
All right, Rich, I appreciate your honesty. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, Rich.
Yeah, you bet. Thanks, guys.
All right, that was Rich Ornberger. He's a former NFL offensive lineman and the co-host of the Mark and Rich Show on Extra 1360 Fox Sports San Diego. Let's take a quick break, but don't go anywhere, because there's more of Beyond the Game coming up next on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Jacob Volk. Jacob Volk.
This damn smirk that you have every time you hit the button, you're like so happy at your creation.
I am.
I don't blame you.
It's like seeing my kid learn to drive, learn to walk, although definitely not in that order.
Learn to shave.
learn to shave. Oh, man, I need that. Gee whiz. Cut myself shaving the other day. It hurt.
You're listening to Beyond the Game on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. We are live twice a week, Tuesdays at 5 p.m. and Fridays at 3 p.m. I am Jacob Volk. You can follow me on Twitter, @RealJacobVolk. Sitting across from me, Dominic Arbolino, who you can follow on Twitter, @Darbs5258. Eric Fischetti, who you can follow on Twitter, @SergeantFish. And Nick Ornberger, who you can follow on Twitter, @NickOrnberger. Number to call if you have something on your mind is 516-572-7444. 800-516-1440. And let's get to football. According to Adam Schefter of ESPN, the Giants are seeking at least two first-round picks for Odell Beckham Jr. Last year, he had 25 catches for 302 yards and three touchdowns. Eric, what are your thoughts on this whole situation?
Let me just start out by saying there was a lot of speculation in terms of Odell Beckham Jr. being traded by a lot of other sources that, to be honest, I chose not to believe unless it was coming from Rappaport or Schefter. But I have to tell you, I don't think it's anything, to be completely honest with you. I don't think the Giants are looking to trade for him, but Gettleman's got some decisions to make. And in terms of, I don't know if it's this year, next year, for future reference, I have no idea. But when you're asking for two first-round picks for a guy of extreme talent like Odell Beckham Jr., disregarding the head case, because a lot of people are like that. It's not just him. But I just don't know what to think about this, to be honest.
I understand.
I really don't.
I understand throughout the season, you know, like, I brought it up a couple of times, you know, like, maybe, you know, are the Giants going to look to trade Odell and, like, in the offseason and all this stuff. But looking at it now and that it's actually, like, coming a reality and, like, you see it, like, trending a little more now, I think the Giants would honestly be dumb to trade Odell Beckham Jr. away. This is a wide receiver that you're not going to get every day again in the draft. You know, like, Odell Beckham Jr. is a really good wide receiver. Obviously, last year, his stats aren't the best because of the injury. We all know that. He literally shattered his ankle. I mean, don't expect him to come back after that. So I understand also you have to worry, like, is he going to be the same after that? I think he's going to be. I think he's going to, you know, maybe he, you know, he could tweak it a little more. Like, it'll be a little more fragile. I don't think it's ever going to be that crazy again, but obviously it can. You never know. But I think it would be dumb. I understand the asking price of two first-round picks, by the way. I understand he's a hot case, but a wide receiver like Odell Beckham
Jr. Of his talent.
It's hard. I mean, it's hard to just be like, all right, here's for a bag of chips. Thank you. Like, it's not going to happen. Like, sorry, Jarvis Landry. Like, he got traded away for, I feel like, nothing.
He really did.
But it's an initial offer, too. You got to keep that in mind.
Of course.
I think they're putting this out there to only get the teams bidding on him who are really serious about getting him, A, and B, they know they're not getting two first-rounders overall for him. They're just not. It's not plausible for another team to give up that much of their future for a wide receiver, albeit he's great, you know.
But one who's a head case.
But he's got so much issue, so much baggage that comes with him. I honestly,
you don't even know if he's going to play the season opener with the drug video that came out. He may be suspended.
Who knows? I mean, I don't even know if they've launched an investigation, but they'd have all the rights to do it.
I mean, I'm torn on this. On the one hand, Odell Beckham is probably the most infuriating player in the NFL, in my opinion. I like him so much. But
you want to strangle him.
I do want to strangle him. I want him to understand that he has the potential to be the best pass catcher in Giant history. And the fact that he doesn't want to win, he doesn't want to be serious, he just wants his money, infuriates me. If a team like the Rams, the Bills, whoever, offered me two first-round picks for Odell, I would really, really think about it. I may do. If it was just one, I don't think I would, because Beckham is that important to the Giants. Whoever the next quarterback is besides Eli, he needs a weapon like Beckham to work with, because if you were to combine the next three or four best offensive weapons on the Giants, they're nowhere close to Beckham.
No, not even close.
In terms of talent. I mean, Beckham is an elite wide receiver in this league. He's one of the five best wide receivers in all of football. Mm-hmm. I like him. I have a picture of his Brandon Carr catch hanging on my wall. I like him a lot, but you know, he needs to just shut up and focus on playing. Enough with the holdout stuff. Stop with that.
I don't
get
think
out
that's
there,
true.
Get out there and earn your contract. For your sake, you better hope you're right.
No, I completely agree with you. For my sake, as a Giants fan, I would really hope that it's not true.
And earn your money. You're not getting $20 million a year. That's number one. Number two, there's no one not playing quarterback who I would give $20 million to. No one. I don't care if it's Emmitt Smith or Jerry Rice. I'm not giving him $20 million a year. You can be the highest paid wide receiver in the league, but you have to go out there and play. You got to earn it. Don't hold out for it. He's an idiot. He's a moron if he thinks he's going to get it that way. He's so infuriating to me. Eric, I don't know how you do it.
Look, honestly, I feel like Odell Beckham Jr. is one of those players that you hate unless he's playing for your team.
No, I don't hate Beckham. I like him. I just am infuriated by him. He's like Muhammad Wilkerson. When Wilkerson was good, he would show up late to practice sometimes. But you know what? You tolerated it because he was good.
Because of the talent.
Then when his play fell off a cliff, he gets suspended and he ends up being cut. But he is exactly like Muhammad Wilkerson. And that's what's going to end up happening to him. He's going to end up being shipped out one way or the other, whether they let him walk in free agency, they trade him. Unless Odell gets his head screwed on straight, he will not be a Giant for too much longer. Because of the culture that Gettleman is trying to build there.
Here's the thing that I want to point out. Gettleman has come out and said multiple times since he's been introduced as the Giants general manager, he kept saying you can't quit on talent.
And he's right.
And he is right. But to be honest, Dom, you pointed out, it would be absolutely stupid for them to trade Odell Beckham Jr. to me, only because someone out said it, and quote, it's basically trading the Jerry Rice of your generation.
I wouldn't go that far. Antonio Brown is the best wide receiver in this league.
Yeah.
So he's Jerry Rice. Odell Beckham is maybe Steve Largent, or another great wide receiver. Pete Retzlaff. How about that? First wide receiver that popped into my head that was really good. Yeah, I see what you're saying. Again, first round pick, I wouldn't do it. Two first round picks, I would. Get your head on straight, or you're not going to be a Giant next year.
Unless someone blows.
And by next year, I mean.
I know what you mean.
Yeah.
Unless
like 12 months from now.
Right. Unless someone blows the Giants away with, like, maybe, I don't know.
Two first round picks.
Maybe.
No.
I'm just saying, people overpay. I'm not saying that's going to happen. Maybe two first, maybe a second. I don't know. People out there can be desperate. I'm not really sure what they're going to do, but whoever wants to trade for Odell Beckham Jr. might have to bargain their future. That's all I'm trying to say. But
you're right. You're 100% right.
But to be honest, I really don't think a Beckham trade is going to come to fruition.
I agree with you.
I really don't. I feel like he's just putting it out there saying, all right, yeah, we'll listen to you, but nothing's going to happen.
If Beckham is traded, Eli's not starting. It's that simple.
If Beckham's traded, Eli's gone.
Well, he may stay as a backup. We got about a minute left. It's time for the bottom of the ninth. Dominic, we'll start with you.
We weren't really able to get to the Jets today, so I'm just obviously going to bring them up. When do I not? But, you know, they actually, along with the Jonathan Harrison re-signing that, you know, Jacob, you had on here, unfortunately, like I said, we weren't able to get to, but they had Travis Swanson in for a visit, and I was confused about that when I saw it, because you think they signed Spencer Long to play center, they re-signed their backup center, who I like better than Wesley Johnson, who's now a Detroit Lion, thank God. But, you know, it's kind of interesting. I mean, maybe if they're thinking about moving him to, like, left guard, I don't know, but it's weird.
Yeah,
just focus
really
on the draft,
is.
Please. Thank you.
Eric?
So, I know that we didn't get to it, but opening day is a very happy time, but for the New York Mets organization and for baseball as a whole, Rusty Staub has unfortunately passed away at the age of 73, and when my dad was 12 years old, he was one of my dad's favorite players. He was the one that was really the catalyst for the Mets' 1973 run,
yep.
And he's the only player in Major League history to record 500 or more hits with four different MLB teams. He was a doll in New York and in Montreal, and he will be missed.
He's a future Hall of Famer. Nick?
All right, Loyola, I'm finally on the bandwagon. Let's see a miracle. That's all I want to say. Let's beat Michigan, and then, I think it'll be Villanova. Beat Villanova. Let's see the miracle happen.
I hope so. So, Passover starts tonight, and I hope you have a Zissin Pesach if you celebrate, and a Happy Easter if you celebrate. If you don't, that's okay, too. All right. Looks like we're out of time here on Beyond the Game. For Dominic Arbolino, Eric Fischetti, and Nick Ornberger, I am Jacob Volk saying that my only regret in life is that I can't be in my car and listen to myself on the radio.